If you guys are looking for super cheap, fast, and reliable Madden 21 coins, look no further than my sponsor, MuttReserve.com. Coins are currently discounted, guys. They got 24/7 support. They're super awesome to work with. Head on over, use code Poodle for an additional 15% off your order. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. And today, we got Wild Card Wednesday, heavyweights, updates, a title update, guys. It's a great day. Madden's back. It feels great. Now, Wildcard Wednesday is one of the most exciting things they could be adding this year. It all depends on how they implement it, but so far, it seems like it's going to be really cool. I'll get into explaining that. I'll go over all the heavyweights. I'll go over everything in this video, but guys, before we do, I do want to let you guys know, like I said in the community tab yesterday, I will be starting the Poodle Squad. It's our Noti Gang Squad, guys. All you guys commented anyways, so let's make it official. So today's shout-out goes to Kenneth Gaming. Shout-out to you for responding to the community tab. He was the first one to do it, so I'm giving it to him. Now, guys, the way you're going to be able to get shouted out in every video, very, very simple. Go down below, next to the subscribe button, hit the Noti bell, turn on all notifications, like the video, and comment down below Poodle Squad. It's that simple. You do that, and you will be shouted out. So most of you guys will probably be shouted out throughout the year, so just keep commenting. You're going to hear your name, but it's always fun to shout someone out. I also will be giving away a gift card today, so stay tuned throughout my videos to figure out which one it actually is. $25 PSN or Xbox, depending on your console. But yeah, guys, today, make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel. Don't forget that, guys. I really appreciate you guys all coming back for all the new content. And yeah, let's get into everything. Don't forget to join the Poodle Squad. And I think we covered all. Oh, and if you need coins for these new heavyweights or Wildcard Wednesday or any of this, and you're probably going to, or training, which you can buy directly, go down below to MuttReserve.com. They recently just cut their prices down, like by in half, like a crazy discount. If you use code Poodle, you get an additional 15% off. Make sure to go take advantage, guys. You don't want to miss this. So, guys, Wildcard Wednesday, to explain, in essence, pretty much every Wednesday, it's going to be a wild card content drop. So heavyweights already, but wild card content drop in terms of they're going to take a previous promo that we've had or currently have and give us extra content for it. So today's heavyweights, like they're going to top it off. So we got five new heavyweights today. Now, it could be next Wednesday, we get our typical two or three heavyweights and maybe we get a team of the week, an extra team of the week card or a legend card or a most feared card in terms of when most feared's out. So it appears like the way they're going to go about this pretty much. And that was my prediction when I was talking yesterday. I assume Wildcard Wednesday would just be a wild card drop of any card we have. So pretty much, guys, if there's any promos that you like, it seems like we'll be getting a random content drop on a Wednesday, which I think is super cool. Because like on a Wednesday, they give us an extra team of the week, Saquon Barkley, we didn't get because you thought he should have gotten one. They give us extra flashbacks, extra veterans, extra heavyweights, maybe a random midweek legend drop. I think it could be super fun. It'll add more variable, like more variants to like the Wednesday, like, oh, what could come out today? It gives us a little bit of a surprise. But that's about it for that, guys. Wildcard Wednesday, super fun. We got a whole offensive line. We got a left tackle, left guard, center, right guard, and right tackle. Tied for some of the best alignment in the game, guys. I really like this. I told you, heavyweights are super awesome in the beginning of the year because we do go ahead and get a ton of content here. Now, I'm going to show you guys the price of them first and kind of go over how you get them. You do need training. So like I said, if you need training, head over to Mutt Reserve because that's what you use to get them. So come over to the store. Coming over to, let's see, training. Nope. Is it featured? Or was I literally just saw it before? Oh, right here. I'm blind. 89 overall heavyweight players, 3,800, and you can pull any of the five. Now, they're all 89, so it's not like you're really taking a risk here. You're pretty much going to spend the training, get the card. Very simple. Now, heavyweights are fire. These new ones are fire. They're going to be top in the top 10 linemen for sure out of all of them. I really like them. Now, again, Wildcard Wednesday today was just extra heavyweights. In another week, it could be heavyweights and legends today. Like, it could be a super interesting promo, guys. Not gonna lie. Now, let's go check their prices out. Go over some of their stats. Check them out. So, first, we got 190K for Laramie Tunsil as the first one. Probably the worst one if he's the cheapest. So, let's see. He's got 88 strength, 90 awareness, 88 pass block, 89 pass block power, 86 pass block finesse, 82 run block, 81 run block power, 84 run block finesse. So, it's pretty simple why he's the lowest priced. He has bad run block. Now, again, take that with a grain of salt in terms of the fact that most left tackles at this stage of the game typically only pass block. There's guys like Brian Bulaga. Now, some can do both, but if they can do both, they'll both be mid-85s. I mean, of course, there's going to become better left tackles that do everything. But right now, if you're a heavy passer, you don't run too much, or you got to, you know, you're getting sacked a lot, a guy like Laramie Tunsil is going to shore up all pass blocking concerns. He might not be the best run blocker, but maybe that's when you do inside zone right, outside zone right, pitch right. Stay away from the left side if you really have to. Could it become a little bit, a little bit obvious what you're doing? Possibly. But if you need a good sure-up tackle to make sure that they don't let anyone come through the blind side, he's your guy. Kevin Zeitler. Now, guys, here's the funny thing. They gave us a Giants offensive lineman. It's very interesting because I don't know what Giants offensive lineman deserves almost a 90 overall because I watch Giants games. There's no holes. Funniest part is all the cards got action shots on the field, and Zeitler got a face card, Why? Because there's no pictures of a Giants lineman blocking. They're probably letting up a sack. It's very interesting that they gave us a Giants guy. But it is what it is. 88 strength, 90 awareness, 89 pass block, 89 pass block power, 87 pass block footwork. Finesse. 82 run block, 84 run block power, and 80 run block finesse. Again, a bad run blocker. Good pass blocker, apparently. But, again, if you just need pass blockers, he's a good guy. Now, at my guard spot, I typically don't like to sacrifice my run block. I do a lot of inside runs. And when your guards can't run block, it really destroys. Even stretchers, like on a stretch, a guard that can't run block can let in a hook off the edge. A shed, not directly off the edge, but on the right guard spot. Or if they have to pull for a run or just anything. I'm typically not a fan of right guards or left guards or centers that can't run block. Now, if you're not a runner, that's fine. Go ahead and get the pass block guarantee. But not my guy. But there are some really fine, like, they're all great. Like, honestly, that level of pass block is still amazing. Now, Richie Incognito is one of the best ones. 89 strength, 91 awareness, 84 run pass block, 86 run, oh my lord. 86 pass block power, 82 pass block finesse, and we got 88 run block, 89 run block power, and 86 run block finesse. Again, the pass blocking is good enough, but he's going to become a threshold run blocker if you put zone run on him. He's looking great. 89 strength. Now, I don't know what his lead block is. Let's see if we can see it here. Impact block is the 89, and his lead blocking is at 89 as well, guys. Powered up and chemmed up, he's going to be probably like the best or one of the best run blockers in Madden right now. So that's super, super interesting to see. He's a great guy at left guard. If you want a power running scheme or like anything, a zone running scheme, you get Larry Allen or you get one of these, Larry Allen, Richie Incognito, and then the new Brandon Linder, which let's go find him as well. Brandon Linder, which I think is really good as well. Set up for the Jaguars. 86 strength, 89 awareness, 87 pass block, 89 pass block power, 87 pass block finesse, 88 run block, 89 run block power, and 84 run block finesse. So again, very well rounded. I think he might be the best card of the drop because, again, powered up and chemmed up, he's going to be a threshold run blocker most of his parts. Threshold pass blocker, he's going to be high 80s to low 90s and everything. He's probably the best guy of the bunch, and that's perfect for a center, guys. He has the high awareness, which is important. We'll hit 90, which awareness is important for centers. He's going to be able to simultaneously not let a pressure and secure the interior line. I think that's so important. Center makes a big deal. People don't realize it. People are like, oh, I don't need a center that pass block. It's not necessarily true because when a center can't pass block too well, sometimes the left guard, the center never lets up sacks that often, right? Because if a center is letting up a sack, the left guard or the right guard might shift over. Like on the beginning of the play, if the defensive tackle gets a good good jump off the snap, the left guard might double team to his side, and then the right tackle comes down to get to his guy, or the left tackle comes down, and before you know it, this guy off the edge. You might be blaming it on your outside blockers, but it could just be because your center couldn't handle the guy. So Brandon Linder looks super awesome. Definitely going to be a scoop for my team. That's why I was just selling Jason Kelce, because Brandon Linder fits exactly what I need. And then we got one last one, which I believe is Lane Johnson. Now, Lane Johnson's really, really good. I have him powered up already, so pretty cool that I had him already. So 83 strength, 89 awareness, 86 pass block, 88 pass block power, 85 pass block finesse, 88 run block, 87 run block power, 87 run block finesse. As per usual, guys, Lane Johnson is what he is. One of the most well-rounded right tackles. Chemmed up, powered up, everything. Will be a high 80, low 90 pass block guy, and a high 80, low 90, depending on what you put on him, run block guy. Going to be the most well-rounded right tackle. Going to be able to do everything. And the beauty of him is also his speed. So he has great speed. He should have, I believe, great impact blocking at an 89 and great lead blocking at an 89 as well. So he'll get that to 90 both sides. Powered up. He'll be 90 overall. And the beauty of him is, on outside run plays, pitches, or any of that stuff, you do have to realize that that is so important to have that speed in Excel, because if you do like a pitch and he comes off, or he gets left alone, he goes upfield, that speed is a big difference. When you have guys like Bo and Barry, they're going to outrun their blockers a lot of the time, so it's really good to have a guy that can run ahead and make that block before you get there, because if they make the block right as you're there, you have to slow down, they could reach tackle you, you have to go around them, but if they make the block upfield, you can run a defender around them. Super important to have a guy that fast. Lane Johnson's probably the best right tackle in the game, or at least tied for it. Now, guys, that pretty much covers our heavyweights. We got 5-state whole offensive line. Now, hopefully in the next week, a wild card Wednesday, don't give us more heavyweights. They do half heavyweights, or I don't know if that will replace heavyweights, but it is super cool to have a wild card Wednesday as a new thing in the game weekly. Guys, so far, I'm liking Madden. Like, I was upset with no content, but the fact that we now have wild card Wednesdays, a banger team of the week content, and there's still more stuff to come. I think they did a great job so far. Hopefully they can keep this up throughout the year. Guys, about it for the video. Hopefully you guys did enjoy. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button. Turn that noti bell, boys, and join the family. Make sure to do a big thumbs up. If you guys want to join the Poodle Squad and have a chance to be shouted out, guys, all you gotta do is comment down below, Poodle Squad, like the video, and turn on that noti bell, boys. Once you do all those things, you're entered, And good, and you're entered for the year. So all you got to do after that is just always like and comment. So remember, once you turn the noti bell on, all you got to do is like and comment every video. And the best thing is to, you probably want to do it in all three or four of the videos, because that's the one I'll see the most if you do four of them. And you can do multiple entries, guys. Doesn't matter. The more you do, probably the more I'll see. So good luck with that. Smash the like button. Can we get 150 likes for today's banger Wildcard Wednesday in heavyweights? Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm out. Enjoy the rest of your day. Make sure to be on the lookout for the gift card. Peace.